deep. Carpentieri kicks it off, and Syracuse and Colgate are underway. Ehrenberg at the 1 yard line. Ehrenberg to the 15, to the 20, to the 25, to the 28 yard line. About a 27 yard return by Rich Ehrenberg, Colgate's leading ground gainer of the opening kickoff. Colgate quarterback number 5, Steve Calabria, a sophomore out of Carl Place. The other skilled positions manned by Mike Kovach, number 88, 30, Mike Bone, 20, Joe Kozak. Ehrenberg over the 35 to near the 37-yard line. He needed the 38, so he gets 9 yards on first down.
Great little cutback. They play started one direction, and Ehrenberg cut back against the grain, something Syracuse had some problems with. There's Ehrenberg, plants the foot, cuts right up the middle, finally stopped by Reed, the linebacker, but picked up 9.
I formation, 2 wide receivers left. There's Ehrenberg again, has the first down and more to the 43-yard line.
Ehrenberg's their leading rusher, and in talking to Coach Dunlap before the game and some of the Syracuse players, they felt that Colgate was going to establish their running game, and there's the people they've got to run against, that 3-4 alignment hand, Reed, Romano, and Roach, the linebackers, Fredrickson, Bellamy, Hobby, and Roos, of course, the secondary. There was some question about Mike Charles playing number 70, but we see him in there starting.
First and 10 for the Red Raiders from their own 43-yard line. I formation, the 2 wide receivers to the open side of the field. There's Ehrenberg again. He is hit by Mike Charles after a 1-yard pickup. Ehrenberg is a 6-foot, 190-pound junior from Chappaqua, New York, down around Westchester County. There is a flag on the play, and the options being discussed with Syracuse's defensive captain, number 54, Tony Romano.
The offensive line we see with Shaw, Thornton, Gil, Owens, and Marini had been some sort of a question mark at the end of the spring. A major rebuilding job was due after last year's fine offensive line. And they're against, of course, that Syracuse defense, which seems to have been getting tougher as the games go on. And right there, this may be an indication of things to come, as a holding call was indicated very early. And when you get up against the guys the size that Syracuse has, sometimes you're going to find a hold taking place.
The referee who just made that call on offensive holding is Bob Bertha. All right, this time the regular pro set eye. Wide receivers both ways. On a delay to Ehrenberg, hit by Chris Hamm at the 39-yard line. Colgate has to get into Syracuse territory to about the 47 for a first down. Ehrenberg now in 3 carries has 20 yards.
Ehrenberg just right up the pipe, outside blocking, good block on Green and number 98, Blaze Winter. Chris Hand comes over from the outside to make the tackle. Still second and about 13.
Calabria on the run. It is knocked down, almost intercepted by Derek Fredrickson. Pass was intended for their split end number 30, Mike Bone, B-O-N-E. Almost picked out of the air by Derek Fredrickson.
They ran a false trap. Calabria's guards pulled, and then Calabria comes around on the opposite side where the play looked like it was going. He had a man open, but you see the free safety, Derek Fredrickson, doing just what he's supposed to do, playing center field. When he sees the ball, knows where it is, he commits himself and just missed an interception.
Third and 13 from their own 39-yard line. Calabria back to throw. Broken up at the Syracuse 47-yard line by number 40, John Roos, who's filling in for the injured Eddie Coban. Eddie broke his elbow and is lost for the season.
Talked to Eddie earlier, they had to do surgery. It wasn't just a simple break. They had to put some pins in and wires, and kidded about the fact he might be able to pick up local radio stations on his elbow. But he feels that he's going to be all right, might not be ready for spring practice, but for next year he thinks he'll be all set.
He says he can't remember exactly how it happened, but he thinks he might have smashed it against a helmet. Fourth down, back for Syracuse. Hobby and Bruckner, the punt is blocked. And it's going to go out of bounds somewhere inside the 20-yard line at about the 17.
We talked about intensity earlier with the coaches, and Blaze Winter, number 98, is probably the most intense young man on that Syracuse defense. He's only a junior. And that defensive line with a big surge came up with a good punt block, going to get Syracuse the ball on about their 17 of Colgate.
Syracuse has not scored a touchdown in the opening period of any football game this year. High formation, Todd Norley is the quarterback. Ziegler and Covington, the running back. There goes Ziegler. Hauled down by number 59 for the Red Raiders, Tim Driver, the right linebacker.
Interesting call, of course. Everyone from Colgate ready for Covington to get the ball because Covington's had such good progress offensively the last two games, and I think they felt perhaps Covington might be the man to get the ball. They crossed him up, and Ziegler picked up about three.
Second and seven from the 14-yard line. In motion is Mike Morris, number 36. The pitch to Covington behind Ziegler. Ziegler misses the block. And the Red Raiders, number 26, Carl Boykin, youngster out of Utica Free Academy in Utica, New York, upends Covington after a short gain of about a yard.
So after a big turnover, Syracuse may give Colgate a lift here if they can't do something with it. There's the score by quarters, as you mentioned, Carl. Syracuse not having much luck in the first quarter, coming on strong in the second and sort of consistent through the third and fourth, so very important for them to get a touchdown here.
This time the running backs get split behind Norley, the quarterback. Wide receivers both ways, open field to the left. Norley gets away once, but not a second time, as 81 Johnny Kimmel brings him down. John Kimmel, the brother of Syracuse's Jamie Kimmel and Jerry Kimmel. Two Kimmels at Syracuse, one Kimmel at Colgate, and that Kimmel made the play, and it is now fourth down, and we're going to get a Russ Carpentieri field goal attempt from about the 21-yard line, so we're looking at a 31-yard field goal attempt.
Blown assignment right there. Matt Walker, the offensive guard, couldn't get out in time to pick up number 68, Marty Murphy, so the result is a field goal attempt.
And it doesn't get there. Did that get blocked, Dale?
It looked like there was either a hand on it or he just took something off and came up short. The result, of course, is the same as Syracuse misses the field goal attempt after a golden opportunity on a blocked punt. And they come up with nothing.
They started on the 17-yard line with first and 10 after the blocked punt. Wind up missing a 31-yard field goal. I thought I heard a slap. It was very hard to tell what happened to it, but it surely did come up very short, and the Red Raiders have held and got the ball back. Number 34 for Colgate, Stacy Hall, gets across the 20 to maybe the 23-yard line. Hall is a sophomore from Toms River, New Jersey. Raiders have second and seven, 10.5 minutes remaining in the first period. Open field to Calabria's right. Looks like he just audible. Changed the play at the line of scrimmage. The pitch goes to Hall. He cuts back and then stumbles at about the 23-yard line, right at the line of scrimmage.
What an offense whereby when they run the eye, we've got a Syracuse player down where they find daylight and they just run to it. And that's Blaze Winter with an ankle. He's had an ankle injury all year. And it gets better in stages, and you can see the frustration right there on Blaze Winter as that right ankle has obviously been hurt in this last series, and they're not particularly have a lot of depth at defensive tackle. Mike Charles, although he's playing, got banged up last week against Pittsburgh, and with number 98, Blaze Winter hurting, if they have to bring in another tackle, we may see him dipping into the second string, Carl.
Winter from Tappan Zee High School in Blauvelt, New York, also down in the southeastern part of New York State. And there is Steve Calabria, the Colgate quarterback. Last year against Syracuse, 22 out of 44 for 279 yards and three touchdowns. Calabria is from the island, Carl Place, C-A-R-L-E, Carl Place. Plays Winter now stepping gingerly on his injured ankle. And coming to the sideline.
Talked to Coach Dunlap before the game about his walking wounded, and he said he had some, but he didn't believe that he'd seen a team have as many injuries as Syracuse has seemed to have had with Coban and all the people that end up getting hurt as this season begins to wind down. So he feels he's pretty healthy.
Third and seven for Colgate. One setback this time, three split receivers. Calabria back to throw. He's got a lot of time. It is deflected but caught anyway and brought out to about the 30-yard line, which is right on the spot that they needed for the first down. 34, Stacy Hall was the receiver. And the referee's got to take a good, hard look at it. It is just short of the 30-yard line. And the referee says they needed just beyond the 30, so it is about 6 inches short. There's the reception. See where the ball comes down. Well, they didn't really give him all he got, did they, Bill?
They give him where the knee goes down, and apparently they spotted it back a foot or so.
For Syracuse.
All right, this will be the second punt for the Red Raiders. Syracuse with 9 rushers at the line of scrimmage, but they've got a return on, and this time the punt is away. Bruckner at the 38-yard line. Doing a lot of dancing, but he didn't go anywhere, and he's down at the 42.
Good punt coverage by Colgate.
Syracuse had 9 at the line of scrimmage, but just as the ball was snapped, they made their initial charge and then turned and came back downfield to try to set up the blocking wall for the punt return, but there wasn't one. 43-yard punt, 4-yard return.
And a 15-yard penalty.
Please go to the management office. William Schaffler to the management office.
Here's referee Bob Bertha to make the announcement.
Dead ball foul. Defense.
Dead ball foul after the play was blown dead. A foul against Colgate, 15 yards worth. And Syracuse has the ball at the Colgate 43. Norley is the quarterback. Bruckner left and Marcus Hackett right. Jamie Covington gets to the 40 and maybe the 39-yard line.
Definitely the bread and butter back for Syracuse University. Covington getting a lot of work lately. Had 100 yards against Penn State. Had a good game against Pittsburgh. Had a 54-yard touchdown run against that defense called back. And I think we'll see a lot of Jamie Covington with the ball today. We're also looking for Harold Gayden perhaps to check in at fullback occasionally.
This time Hackett is left and Bruckner to the right. I formation. The pitch to Covington. And Jamie gets to the 35-yard line. Syracuse has to get to the 33 for a first down. So it'll be third and about 2 for the Orange. 8 minutes and 15 seconds remaining in the opening period. No score, Syracuse and Colgate on homecoming weekend from the Carrier Dome in Syracuse, New York.
Number 50 for Colgate's Dave Wolf, the linebacker and co-captain, is a man to watch. He's all over the field and one of the best tacklers on the team. Number 50, Dave Wolf, stopped that last play for the Colgate Red Raiders. That's the same play they scored on against Pittsburgh.
He's out of bounds at the 2-yard line. There's a flag back at the 35, but I think it was against Colgate.
I believe it'll be offsides. They went in a staggered count. I think I saw a Colgate man. Yeah, we get the call. It's offsides against Colgate. And actually, that will be declined. And that was the same play, Carl, if memory serves me correctly, that Covington scored on against Pittsburgh, which, of course, as we know, was called back. And he just breaks it to the right and cuts back against the grain. The blocking on the outside was great, and he made it down to about the 1-yard line. Watch Covington. There he goes. They get the defense going one way, and he cuts back against the grain. Very difficult to stop Covington when he's got that much speed.
Straight T formation. The give is to Covington, and Jamie is in for the touchdown. Covington's first touchdown of the season and the first one Syracuse has scored in the opening period of play.
And the fans love it. Sounds almost as loud as it did against Pittsburgh last week.
Russ Carpentieri, who is 8-for-8 so far this season, will attempt to make it 9 out of 9. Extra points, it's up. It's good, and Syracuse leads 7-0 with 7:39 remaining in the first period at the Dome.
After being frustrated on that blocked kick, the Syracuse offense, which really seems now to be revolving around the running of Jamie Covington, certainly benefited from him on that big run, took him down to the 1-yard line. And as you said, Carl, this game, I think Colgate last year, Joe Morris scored on the first play of the game, 75 yards, and Colgate never gives up. They came right back, and it was a very, very exciting game last year.
That's right. After Joe Morris' 75-yard touchdown run, 17 seconds into the ball game last year here at the Dome, Colgate, within 2.5 minutes, came back to score on a 3-yard pass from Calabria to Bennett. Bennett is gone, but Calabria is still here.
I noticed something interesting on the kickoff, Carl. They double-teamed the kicker, Russ Carpentieri, right there on the blocking assignments, and they had a pretty good run back. Syracuse special teams may have a little bit of difficulty. But, of course, that really helps when you kick the ball 9 yards deep in the end zone. Good kick for Carpentieri. Good coverage downfield.
Colgate now behind 7-0 to the Orange. Will put it in play at the 20-yard line. This will be the third time the Red Raiders have had the football here in the opening period of play. Syracuse and Colgate began in 1891. This is the 64th meeting between these two clubs and will be the last one for the next 4 years. Colgate comes back on the schedule in 1987. Looking to throw. Good strong arm. Out of bounds. Incomplete. Double coverage on the intended receiver. And he threw that one into the stands, I think, to make sure that nobody picked it off. It was intended for Joe Kozak, number 20. Took Syracuse 1:23 to score that touchdown. The big play was Jamie Covington's 35-yard run to the 1-yard line, and then on the next play, from a straight T formation, Covington took it in for the touchdown. And there's Jamie, youngster from Bayside High School, Queens, New York. Calabria to number 34, Stacy Hall, and he gets to the 25-yard line.
They love that delay. Colgate loves to have those back find that hole. See where it opens, go for it. There's Stacy Hall's stats, 854 yards, 170 rushes.
Third and five for the Red Raiders. They are predominantly in white with maroon trim. Maroon helmets and a maroon stripe down the side of the pants. Calabria throws on the run. May have been caught at the 35-yard line by number 80 for the Red Raiders, Tony Rogers.
Pass complete to number 80.
It was complete. He made a diving catch, picked it right off the Astro circuit. Before, when Stacy Hall stumbled, Dale, I was going to say, there's the catch by Rogers. This may be the first and only ball game that Colgate plays on artificial surface this year. Syracuse has played only one on grass, and Colgate, I think, plays almost all their ball games on grass, with the exception maybe of Pennsylvania. If they play it down there, I think Penn has an artificial surface.
Temple may also.
You can pick them up at Stadium Control.
Veterans Stadium, I don't know where they...
They played Cornell down in Ithaca, and Schoelkopf Field also has artificial surface.
This artificial surface, if you walk on it, you notice that it kind of throws you one way or the other, and if you're not used to playing on it, it can be a little bit tricky to get used to, and there's number 10, Hobby.
Ron Hobby was the injured player.
And he's got ankle trouble. They've had a lot of ankle problems this year, and you see Calabria just passed 3,000 yards for passing in his career, and he's only a sophomore. He's 6'4", and that helps the quarterback a lot and able to see his receivers.
First and 10 for the Red Raiders from the 35-yard line. There's Ehrenberg. Gets tripped by John Bruce, number 40, as he tried to turn the corner. He rolled forward for a couple of yards.
John Bruce,
and they're spotting the ball at about the 38-yard line, so give him 3 yards. Second and 7. Ehrenberg now with 4 carries and 23 yards. 6 minutes left in the opening period. Syracuse in front, 7-0 on a Jamie Covington touchdown. High formation, 2 wide receivers. A fake into the line and a float down the field, intercepted by Derek Fredrickson. Fredrickson to the 40 and out of bounds at about the 34-yard line. That is Derek Fredrickson's first interception of the season and the ninth for the Syracuse secondary. The leading interceptor is Tony Romano with three. The ball was thrown much too high for the intended receiver, number 88, Mike Kovach, right into Derek Fredrickson's hands. Got Chris Hand, 89, in front of him, trying to use him effectively. And gets knocked out of bounds. So the Orange has the ball back. Norley is the quarterback from the 34-yard line. Bruckner, 13, in motion. Jamie Covington to the 32-yard line. Hit first by number 56, Jeff Knight. Also on the play, number 59, Tim Driver. Driver's been in on, as I can recall it now, every single defensive play for the Red Raiders so far in this ballgame, every running attempt by Syracuse. Short gain, second and eight. Open field to Todd Norley's left. Harold Gayden running from the up-back spot gets to the 26-yard line.
Colgate doing something interesting. They dropped it. They're using like a 3-4 alignment, but they dropped the defensive tackle back off the line at the last minute, and then they run what's called a twist or an X stunt with the nose tackle, the nose guard. The nose guard goes to his right, and the tackle loops around him to the left. So they're playing games up front, hoping to confuse the Syracuse offensive line.
Third and three for the Orange on the Colgate 27-yard line. Jamie Covington. Jamie to the 13-yard line. That will be a first down for the Orange at the 13. After Covington picks up about 13 yards, giving him 59 so far in the ballgame.
Give Bruckner as much credit as Covington.
Yes,
we'll see his block on the outside right there. Perfect body position by Bruckner. And it lets Covington motor up inside the block.
First and 10 from about the 13 or 14 yard line. Wide receivers both ways for the Orange. The pitch to Covington. 10 to the 5 and in for a touchdown.
Jamie Covington, what a great display of running. That play was shut down inside, and Covington just turned on the speed. Carl took it outside end zone. The play was not designed to go there. Great run by Covington. Incidentally, Carl, one of the officials got knocked down on that play.
Carpentieri looking to make it 10 for 10, extra points. There it is. And it is good. Up into the upper deck. And Syracuse leads 14 to nothing with 4 minutes and 8 seconds still remaining in the opening period of play here at the Carrier Dome. There's the pitch. Covington
is 8 carries for 74 yards.
Breaks a couple tackles and then just outruns everybody into the end zone. Jamie Covington with now 8 carries. 73 yards. He's on his way to some kind of afternoon against the Colgate Red Raiders here at the Dome.
He certainly deserves it. We've mentioned before that Jamie Covington, a hard luck kid, been injured quite a bit, but boy, he's really playing this year injury free, and it shows because his potential I don't think has been realized, and Coach McPherson just had his fingers crossed before the season started that Jamie would be able to stay injury free, and so far this year, especially the last 3 games, Carl, coming on very strong. Couldn't happen to a nicer kid.
Russ Carpentieri ready to kick it off high and end over end at the 2-yard line. There is a flag on the play, returned by number 20 Joe Kozak out to about the 17-yard line, but there's a flag back of the Syracuse kicking line. And some of the Orange players are already moving back.
Please come to the management.
It was an offside, Carl. I saw the right end
to the management office
go over the line just before the ball was kicked.
Offside! Re-kick!
They will re-kick it from 5 yards farther back, so that'll tee it up at the 35-yard line.
Might have been Ken Jagiello, number four, the transfer from Navy, but 1:34 in the elapsed time on that drive, 34 yards and a 14-yard run, culminating that drive by Jamie Covington. And I think he ran a lot further than 14 yards to make it.
Syracuse, which had not scored a touchdown in the opening period of play so far this season, has now scored twice. Jamie Covington had not scored a touchdown either, and he's got both of them. Long floating kick. Ehrenberg at the goal line. Ehrenberg to the 25-yard line for a 25-yard kickoff return by Rich Ehrenberg. And the Red Raiders have the ball at the 25, first and 10, with 3:57 remaining in the first period.
We talked to Coach McPherson, said even though his record is 1-6 coming into this game, the fans seem to be appreciative of the team's effort. What was his reaction?
We recognize that we better start winning pretty soon. And that's something that I will never forget for the reception that I had and the loyalty and support they've given to our program.
There's
a
flag.
Turn my back on them.
Ehrenberg is caught at the line of scrimmage. The referee, who was in the Colgate backfield, threw the flag, and his preliminary indication is illegal motion by the Red Raiders. Syracuse probably shake that one off.
Well, it's going to be offsetting penalties. As Syracuse was offside, the line judge threw his flag in the Syracuse backfield at the same time the flag was thrown in the Colgate offensive backfield. So we should get offsetting penalties here and play the down over.
All right, so we'll start from the 25-yard line again. First and 10 for the Red Raiders, just like that play never happened. Number 20, Joe Kozak, comes wide to the left. 80, Tony Rogers is to the right. They run it straight ahead and pick up about 5 yards to the 30-yard line. Rich Roach, 38, in on the play. Romano, 54. 35, Rudy Reed. Number 70, Mike Charles.
Notice that David Lee just checked out. Chris Hamm checked back in. Lee's the nickelback, and they put 5 defensive backs in. They replace a linebacker. Now Hand is back in at second and fairly short. Gambling that Colgate's probably going to run the ball.
Calabria made a change at the line of scrimmage. He gives it to Ehrenberg deep. Ehrenberg bounced out of bounds at the 40-yard line by Derek Fredrickson, but he got the first down.
Great run by Ehrenberg. It looked like he was going to be tackled by Romano, but Ehrenberg showed a lot of good speed. Watch him take this outside. He's supposed to run to daylight. There's Romano, missed the tackle. Roos up and misses the tackle. And Derek Fredrickson finally bumps him out of bounds in front of the Colgate bench. Good run for Ehrenberg to pick up an important first down. Colgate's going to take a timeout. I think they had a little trouble getting the play in. A little bit reminiscent of Pittsburgh last week as Coach Dunlap going to talk to Steve Calabria. That's Coach Dunlap. Very nice, personable fellow.
Oh, he is terrific. Colgate with 31 wins to Syracuse's 27. 5 games have been ties. Last year, Syracuse won it 47-24. Freddie Dunlap, the athletic director and head coach at Colgate University, is a 1950 Colgate graduate, played in a couple of Syracuse Colgate games. He was a fullback for the Red Raiders in his playing days. A native of Carbondale, Pennsylvania, was the head coach at Lehigh for 11 years, and this is his 7th year as head coach at Colgate. His overall coaching record, 92 wins, 85 losses, and 4 ties. 3 minutes and 5 seconds left to play. First period, Syracuse leading 14-0. The Red Raiders have it at the 40-yard line, first and 10. 3 wide receivers. Calabria again changing the play, hollering out to his 2 wide receivers who are split way to his left. And he throws on the run to Ehrenberg. In Syracuse territory, 15-yard pickup. Ehrenberg, his tailback, was the inside wide receiver, well out to the near sideline. Ehrenberg just broke with the snap, and Calabria floated one to him. Vic Bellamy, with help from Hobby, made the stop. It's a Colgate first down at the Syracuse 45-yard line. Same formation, except the wide receivers are right this time. The pass was whistled right by number 88, Mike Kovach, before he had a chance to get his hands up. I think Calabria threw it early.
I think you're right, Carl. Also, I think that that's a nice pattern they ran before that. It's just a little slant, and Calabria comes up and throws it so quickly, and if you have any kind of cushion by your defensive backs, it's very tough to stop. The theory being, get the ball to Calabria where he's out one-on-one away from the interior of the Syracuse defense and see what he can do. He picked up 15. They look like they might try it again. It was incomplete. Second and 10.
A variety of offensive formations, and nobody knows where to go on this one, and Calabria calls a timeout. He had all of his skill position guys running back and forth behind him, trying to figure out who was supposed to be where, and Calabria called a timeout.
Pittsburgh had the same problem. A lot of people say that Syracuse's defense is tough to read. It's tough to come up and see exactly what they're doing. Their alignment is essentially the same, but they move people around, and just a little bit of movement can throw off the coverage or add something to the offensive. They've got to solve an additional problem, and Colgate, having a little bit of trouble, as you mentioned, called a timeout, and they're going to try to get it straightened out.
Still in the first period, 2 minutes and 37 seconds still remain to be played in the first period here at the Carrier Dome. Colgate has Pennsylvania, Temple, and Boston University left. Syracuse has Navy, Boston College, and West Virginia.
One thing I've noticed about Calabria, his passes don't seem to have the zip. The one that was intercepted by Fredrickson, he kind of floated it, took a little bit of something off it, and the Syracuse defense is converging very well on the ball when they're thrown that way. So I think Calabria is going to try to put a little more zip on the ball, try to get him into the receivers, and not let them converge on that pass.
He's got the arm to do it, too. He can throw the ball hard. We've seen evidence of that. All right, two wide receivers to the right. One setback, and he gets the ball and gets to the 41-yard line. 36, George Stiles was the ball carrier. Rudy Reed, Tony Romano on the stop.
Tackled by Tony Romano and Rudy Reed.
Stiles is a senior from Ithaca, 210-pounder. Here come the Red Raiders to the line of scrimmage. Third and six for Colgate. On the Syracuse 41-yard line. Wide open down the middle is Rogers, and nobody's going to lay a glove on him.
No linebackers on the inside. That was right up over the middle. Nobody in the middle for Syracuse.
That's very similar to the play that cost Syracuse the Temple game, Dale.
Very similar.
The tight end right up the middle, wide open. Calabria laid it right on his numbers, and he went in untouched for the score.
And you notice how Calabria, again, didn't zip that ball, but that's the play they tried before. A similar play, he took a little something off it because there was nobody around him there. It was a great pass and a good touchdown.
They're going to go for two, but it's going to come up short.
I don't think they went intentionally for two. It was a high snap, and every team, of course, has a play. If it's a high snap, they'll run a break, and they look for a man in the end zone.
They had no choice but to go for two after the bad snap. And the play came up short, and it's now 14-6.
You can tell they saw the Temple game. Watch, there's Reed, 35. Now, he's one of the inside linebackers, and right there, right in his zone, right in his area is where Kovach caught the ball, and there was nobody home because the outside receivers had driven the corners and the safeties out to the outside. And although there was a stunt, your safety's got to help pick up that man. Nobody did it. Touchdown for Colgate. But, of course, the extra point blown makes it 14-6.
41-yard touchdown pass. Calabria to Kovach. Mike Kovach, a senior at 6'3", 230 pounds from Hutchtown, Pennsylvania. Kick it off. Gate 47, Covington 45, RD. Very high, end over end to the 2-yard line, Harold Gayton. And he runs right into number 56, Jeff Knight. At about the 19 or 20-yard line, so that's About a 17 or 18 yard return by the freshman from down in Westchester County, Harold Gayden from Sleepy Hollow High School. Well, they put it just across the 20 at about the 20 and a half yard line, where it'll be Syracuse first and 10. Bruckner is to the right. Hackett to the left. Now Hackett comes in motion back toward the ball. Corley to Covington, and Jamie gets across the 25, about a 5 yard pickup.
Stop by number.
They run basically a 3-4 defense, but they're shifting a little bit as per their scouting reports on Syracuse tendencies. And Wolf, number 50, the linebacker's got a big responsibility.
11 running plays for Syracuse, and Covington has carried on all but three of them. He has 79 yards. There goes Jamie again, but he gets only a short yard. Excellent defensive play. 85 for the Red Raiders. Torrey Mangione.
And driver number 59 in there too. Joe Nett led up through the hole. As we look at the scoring drive of Colgate, Nett led up through the hole, but good penetration by the Colgate defense brought the play down from the backside. So the hole was there on the play side, but they got burned from behind.
Mike Morris is wide left. Marcus Hackett is to the right. Split backs, third down, 4 yards to go. Norley throws, complete to Covington at the 34-yard line, and that should be a first down. Syracuse needed just across the 30, and Covington was tackled at about the 33 and a half or 34, so the Orange gets a first down. Norley cranks it up, fires, hit Covington perfectly, and Syracuse has the first down.
I mentioned Wolf. One of the important jobs, one of the reasons why he's got a lot of responsibility, is that Syracuse has shown a tendency to hit Covington out of the backfield, and Wolf will oftentimes be called upon to bring Jamie down one-on-one.
Norley is now one out of one for 7 yards. Bruckner in motion, goes toward the far sideline. Norley looking that way, lets one hang deep to Hackett. Hackett is out there, can't quite get it.
He had what you call a good 2.5 to 3 step lead on Robinson, the defensive back, Eugene Robinson, on the coverage. And Marcus Hackett, just a good split end, who's starting to come into his own this year. He's had some ups and downs, but he certainly had Robinson beat, just couldn't come up with a catch. Norley also with a pretty good throw. You'll see the difference in the space there between 32 and 41. But I'd say just about maybe 2 or 3 feet overthrown.
Rodney Carter to the short side. Bruckner is to the open side of the field. It is second and 10. Norley to Covington. Jamie's got a lot of room and gets into Colgate territory at about the 49-yard line.
I think it's going to be a clip. We'll see what the call is, but it looks like a clip up on about the 43-yard line, or a hold. Yes, it's a hold. And that's too bad, because Syracuse had a good play on that, but it appeared that one of the linemen on his block maybe slipped that hand out and held him.
Holding. Offense. Second down.
That puts quite a hole. Let's see if we can pick it up.
Didn't seem to be anybody very close to the play who needed to be held.
It was in back. I think it might have been number 71 for the Orange, Teddy Cirillo. I'm not sure. I don't want to blame him for it, but that was the general direction of the flag. Go look at it on the films to see if it was a good call.
And that is the end of the first period, with Syracuse leading Colgate 14-6. Again, our sincere thanks to all of you who have written in to express your appreciation for these ball games. We would very much like to hear from more of you. The more of you we hear from, the better the chance that there will be continued Syracuse University football on the public television stations around New York State. We can provide the games for you. Now we'd like to hear from you, please, so that we can continue to bring you these games next year and hopefully for many years to come. Drop us a line at WCNY Sports, 506 Old Liverpool Road, Liverpool, New York, 13088. And again, our sincere and grateful appreciation. At the end of the first period in last year's Syracuse Colgate game, it was 20-7. Syracuse was leading 20-7. At halftime, Syracuse led 27-14. Gaydon to the 35-yard line.
Pretty good kickoff for Gaydon. And good blocking downfield, but of course, it's going to bring up third and about nine. Gaydon a little bit
first
of a delay.
Penn State seven.
Pretty decent blocking, but of course they needed a lot more than what Gaydon was able to pick up, so it's going to bring up third and nine.
High backs, wide receivers to both sidelines, open field to the right of Norley. Norley to throw. Over the middle, Hackett. Colgate territory at the 49-yard line. Defensive play made by Eugene Robinson as Hackett again goes 4 or 5 feet up in the air to haul it in. Norley with a good throw, delivered it well, and up goes Hackett to bring it in.
You know, when I looked at that early, it didn't look like it had any chance of being caught, but Hackett, look how far the leg went up in the air. He really went up after that one. Marcus Hackett, good catch.
From the Colgate 49. First and 10 for the Orange. Norley with time, lets it go, complete to Drucker at the 35-yard line. Drucker hit by number 10, Curtis Thompson, and number 50, Dave Wolf, and he took a real shot from both. Watch him get hit. He has hit high and low, front and back.
You know, you see Drucker right there did just what he's supposed to, though. He curled right where the first down marker was and then just turned, held onto the ball, and put his head down.
Open field left. Drucker is out that way. Hackett is to the right. Norley to Covington. Jamie to the 20-yard line. That's about a 15-yard pickup for Jamie Covington.
First down, Syracuse.
And that will give him 94 yards and 11 carries.
Play just broke off to the right side. It's just a little bit of a handoff. He reads the daylight and breaks to the outside. Nice blocking up front by Ziegler. And Hackett downfield got down to give another couple of yards.
Covington inside the 20 to about the 19.
Jamie Covington.
Colgate gambling a little bit. Carl Boykin, a defensive back, they sent him over the side there. Look at the statistics. 50 yards rushing for Colgate, 87 for Syracuse, 73 and 7. Total yardage, 123 to 94, but of course the Orange ahead 14 to 6. Third down conversions, impressive for Syracuse, 3 out of 4, something they haven't been able to do very much before this.
Jamie Covington into about the 12-yard line. Ziegler lost his helmet on that play, even before the play got underway. I don't know how his helmet happened to come off.
Because he blocks, and he blocks with his helmet. 13 for 104, Jamie Covington. You know what I like about Covington? The way he twists at that last minute, twists that upper body and really lunges for the extra yard or two. Going to bring him very close to a first down. Jerry Feary going to take a really close look at this. Norley stays with the rest of the offense, and they're probably going to come up about 3 inches short. And Norley indicates to Coach McPherson the distance. And I think we're going to see a thunder offense here. We'll probably see the tight, double tight end, T.
Third down and one.
With Brodsky and Stevens in for the two tight end offense.
Well, let's see who's in there. Glenn Moore, 44. Norley is the quarterback. 47, Gaydon, and 45, Covington. Stevens and Brodsky are the tight end. Norley, quarterback sneak, has the first down inside the 10-yard line.
Good surge, good line surge. You notice Norley just takes one step back after he gets the snap and then just tucks up behind his guard. But the line surge drove back Colgate about a yard and a half right off the ball. Jerry Feary, great block, the captain of the Orangemen, and he gives Norley room to get the first down.
So that makes it first and goal just inside the 10-yard line. Bruckner is in motion. Norley to Covington. Jamie gets hit at the 8-yard line. He got straightened right up by number 59, Tim Driver.
Driver read the play very well. Of course, they're going to be looking for Covington, and boy, did Driver put a hit on him. Blew his chin strap out, and Jamie Covington checks back in anyway, and Ziegler, after losing his helmet, is going to go back in at fullback.
Driver, just a second-year player, 195-pounder from Greenfield, Massachusetts. Number 59, Tim Driver. There goes Hackett in motion on second and goal. To Covington, Jamie wants to throw it. Look at Norley all alone. Touchdown, Covington to Norley. In the huddle. Carpentieri to try to make it 11 straight extra points. It's up. It's good. And Syracuse leads 21-6. And the fans are happy. Happy Halloween. Is that a mask or what?
21-6. You know, that play looks like it's a razzle-dazzle, something as we said backyard. But I'm sure most teams have that kind of throwback in their repertoire. Watch. All Norley does, this looks like a sweep because they've been sweeping Covington all day. Covington just stops, and Norley is snuck out. Nobody's watching him. Who watches the quarterback after he pitches the ball? The answer is, as you see here, nobody. 9-yard touchdown, probably his first and maybe his last touchdown reception. You can only use that play once in a while. Good catch by Norley, the quarterback, in the end zone.
Al Covington has now scored two touchdowns and thrown for one in this ball game. And Syracuse leads 21-6. Still 11 minutes remaining in the first half of play at the Dome. I think the fans are having a real good time.
Well, you mentioned not only are they excited about the fact that they scored a touchdown, but it's exciting to watch that kind of play, and they really showed their appreciation after that.
Ehrenberg at the 4-yard line. Gets to the 22. 18-yard return by Rich Ehrenberg. And the Red Raiders have it again.
I really like that Ehrenberg. I think he really runs hard.
Tackled by Bernie Hedgebeth.
And it's amazing that he not only is the running back, but that he also, the starting running back, he also runs back the kickoffs and the punts. So Calabria's got his work cut out for him now. A lot of time, high scoring game, 21-6 so far in the second quarter.
He has two fullbacks in there now. Lorenzi and Stiles. Number 35, Gil Terenzi, number, oh no, he's got Hall, 34. He's got Hall, the tailback, and Terenzi, number 35. 14-play drive, 80 yards. And the pass, Covington to Norley for the score, took 6 minutes and 46 seconds. Colgate will run. There's Todd Norley, number 12, touchdown receiver. Colgate will run a two fullback offense. There's a whistle and ball is blown dead. They will run a two fullback offense with 35 and 36 Terenzi and Stiles, or they will run one fullback and one tailback. Tailback is either Hall or Ehrenberg.
Carl, you know, we talked to Coach Dunlap at the head of the show, talked about the difference between one double A. And Driver, the defensive, the linebacker for Colgate, is a classic example. He weighs 195 pounds. I don't think on any Division 1A team of Syracuse or any, you'll find a 195-pound linebacker, but Driver really plays very, very tough.
34, Hall, the tailback. He gets the pitch. And he's to the 27-yard line. Gary Kimmel, number 59, and 70, Mike Charles, along with 72, Timmy Green, make the stop. Happy Halloween to you, too. Now, is that a mask?
They score while you're doing this.
Hey, Missy, you didn't get any Coleman.
Back to football.
Two wide receivers left. They are strong right. Tight end is to the right side. Calabria looking left, lets it go. He's got a man open. Completed the 39-yard line to number 20, Joe Kozak.
That's your basic pick play. Two receivers drive off the ball and one cuts off the other one's pick. and we'll see what happens just right here. You watch Bellamy on the left of your screen was going the wrong way because they, both of the defenders, both of the secondary men, broke with the inside man and Calabria threw it to the outside. Good for a long gain, the first down.
And I think you could tell while watching Calabria get set to throw that ball, he had a lot of good protection. Colgate giving him lots of time to throw the ball. Calabria back to throw again. The hit was early, incomplete.
The hit was right on time. Welcome to the dome. Number 30, Mike Bone, the split end. He's 5'10", weighs 175 pounds, and Derek Fredrickson really put the hit on him. Watch him come across. They're coming in opposite directions. Bone comes from the right, and Fredrickson times it perfectly. He and the ball arrive at the same time, at the same address. And there was the man who was the recipient of that pass, Mike Bone out of West Pittston, PA, and I think he's all right, but I think he's got quite a shock.
All right, let's take another look at the hit. Right on time.
To the first aid room, please, and Greg.
Oh yeah, couldn't have been any better.
It was not early, and it was not illegal. It was perfect.
And Gary Blackney, the defensive backfield coach, has got to be very pleased with that hit. That's exactly what he wants his safeties to do. Find the ball, go to it, and put a hit on somebody. Credit Calabria, found him very quickly, and give Bone credit. He knew he was going to get hit, but he held on as long as he could. Brings up second and 10. There's Calabria's numbers, 6 of 11 for 84. One TD, one interception. Carl Calabria's had some interceptions, too. It seems a lot of the quarterbacks, Marino and Syracuse, of course, had their problems.
Well, he's had one today, giving him a total of 17 so far this season. There goes Aaron Berg, hit by Timmy Green. Number 72 and number 83, Gary Kimmel.
How'd you like to be the Kimmel family? Have three sons playing in this college game. One for Colgate, two for Syracuse, of course. The family budget's probably a lot better off since they all on football scholarships.
Gene Schaefer to the first aid room, please.
Jamie Kimmel wearing number 83 for Syracuse. 59 is Jerry Kimmel for Syracuse. And 81 for Colgate is John Kimmel. Bobby was there along with number 20, David Lee. The pass intended for number 12, Tom Burgess.
Hobby is a corner, and he was a corner, been playing safety. They've had to change some positions around since people got hurt, and Hobby, nice job of getting over, helping on the deep coverage.
Burgess, number 12, is a backup quarterback, just a freshman out of Newark, New York. Fourth and 8 from their own 41-yard line. Nice punt. Bruckner back to about the 13-yard line.
He can get a block.
He did get that block.
And they're going to call Bernie Hedgepath on a clip. Boy, that was close. Hedgepath, I thought, might have had the angle to get the head in front, but that's going to put Syracuse down at about their own 5. And the fans don't like it. What a great job Bruckner did of keeping the feet moving. They're going to say that the initial contact was from behind, I'm sure, but Bernie Hedgepath, a lot of credit for trying. It certainly can't cost him more than actually about 5 yards, because I think Bruckner would have been there anywhere. Watch this. Good feet by Bruckner, back and forth.
Awful lot of white shirts there. That was the one block he needed. Got him in the shoulder.
Whoa, that.
Tipping on the run back, first down.
Boy, I don't know about that one, dude.
I think it was right from the shoulder. I think you're right, Carl.
All right, shake it off and play ball. 8.5 minutes remaining, first half, 21-6 Syracuse lead. Chris Tadulu in at quarterback for the Orange, the freshman from Gloversville. Chris Tadulu going to take it himself and winds up either getting back just barely to the line of scrimmage or within a half a yard of it either way.
This game is far from over, and Syracuse does not want to have any problems down here against this defense. I don't think they're going to throw the ball. They certainly don't want to give up a turnover and let Colgate run it in from the 7 or 8 yard line. And they've got a new quarterback, so a little pressure on Chris Tadulu.
Jamie Covington with Ziegler leading the blocking. Covington just across the 10 to about the 11. Defensive play made by John Hoff, number 49.
You know, something I like that I've noticed, Carl, excuse me just a second, I watch on that play, Mike Morris downfield very quickly blocking, and Marcus Hackett has done that. The receivers seem to me today to be blocking a lot better downfield, and they're really very, very aggressive. In case Covington or one of the runners breaks the line of scrimmage, they're going to make sure they've got some open area downfield.
Third and five. Ziegler is the up back and Covington the tailback. Splits to both sidelines. Christodoulou going to throw. Lets one go long. Double coverage intercepted at the 44-yard line. Intended for Hackett, 82. He had a following there. Two defenders right with him.
Double coverage on him. It's probably a trite thing to say, but it's probably as good as a punt. And we got a little stumble there.
He stumbled, that's right. He tripped over number 10, Curtis Thompson. The pass was intercepted by Carl Boykin out of Utica Free Academy. There goes Ehrenberg pushing his blocker out ahead of him and picks up about 7 yards.
Number 70 for the Raiders, offensive tackle Tom Smiley, offensive guard rather. Nice job of blocking down on Mike Charles. Open up a big hole for Colgate to run through. Picked up about five.
For Boykin, that was his fourth interception of the season. He now leads in that department. Calabria to throw. Waited until the last moment. Threw and fired it complete to the 29-yard line. To number 30, Mike Bone, the guy who took the big hit from Fredrickson, comes right back to make a fine catch.
He just got the ball off, and you notice Romano, 54, with Bone, but he can't cover him by himself, and the ball went over his head. Bone made the grab, first down. Don't count Colgate out. I'll tell you right now, they're not going to give up.
36 is Stiles, 22 is Ehrenberg. There goes Ehrenberg on a delay. Timmy Green slows him down, and he is finally put away at the 28-yard line by Tony Romano. Here comes the fifth defensive back into the ballgame for the Orange as David Lee, number 20, comes in for Chris Hand. 6 minutes left to play first half. Syracuse 21-6 over Colgate, but the Red Raiders have the ball at the Syracuse 28-yard line. Second down and nine. Stiles the up back and Ehrenberg the tailback. Calabria back to throw. Being chased by Charles. Being chased by Green. Throws broken up by Bellamy. Nice play.
Timing, the name of the game on that. Bellamy just got the hand in, tapped it away, reminiscent of Ron Hobby against Pittsburgh last week. Calabria forced out of the pocket by Charles. Looked like he could have made a lot of yardage on the run. But he knows the ball travels a lot further and a lot faster than he does, so he lets it go. And there's Hobby right there. The hand didn't hit the back until after the first one hit the ball.
Pass intended for 88, Mike Kovach.
There's Bellamy. Manu made the big play, the safety.
Red Raiders with one offset running back. Calabria to throw. Caught beautifully inside the 10-yard line by Tony Rogers, number 80.
Rogers, good grab. Mike Charles in, not enough pressure.
First down, Colgate.
Just a well-thrown pass.
First and goal for the Red Raiders from the 6-yard line. Rogers, a junior, split end from Palmer, Massachusetts.
He's the brother of Tom Rogers, right. The big split end from last year.
Stacy Hall to about the 5-yard line. And that'll make it second and goal for the Red Raiders of Colgate with exactly 5 minutes remaining in the first half.
Just a little short pitch to Hall. Nothing to the outside. He cut it back up, but good pursuit by Syracuse. Cuts him off after about a gain of a yard.
The Red Raiders threatening, trailing 21-6. Less than 5 minutes now remaining in the first half. At halftime, Syracuse University's legendary football coach, Ben Schwartzwalder, will be officially installed into the National College Football Hall of Fame. There was a dinner last night attended by nearly 1,000 people at the Manly Fieldhouse, a testimonial dinner to honor Coach Schwartzwalder. And at halftime, before what looks like a crowd of about 35,000 fans here at the Carrier Dome, Coach Ben, who heard the cheers of fans for a long time at Old Archbold Stadium, right here in this very same location, will hear more cheers, I'm sure, than he ever heard when he was coaching. You know, when you're coaching, you hear some cheers and you hear some boos, depending on how the last play call went and what your record is. But I'm sure that Benny will get the accolades of every person in this stadium here at the Dome this afternoon, as he is acknowledged as a great human being, a fine football coach, a credit to the college team. For the Red Raiders, from just inside the 5-yard line, two wide receivers, both to the right side of Calabria. The pitch to the short side, down to the 1-yard line. Number 35 is the ball carrier, Gil Terenzi.
Gil Terenzi,
boy, that junior from Elmont, New York, takes it down to the 1-yard line, and here comes the big heavy stuff. Pendock, number 99, and number 93, Ralph Jolene. They're bringing in the 250 and 280 pounders to beef up the center of the defensive line. The Red Raiders have third and goal from the half-yard line. Terenzi again. Terenzi in for a touchdown.
They ran the same play three times and netted him a touchdown. And Colgate right back in this and probably going to go for the two-point conversion, and we'll be right back in it regardless whether they get the conversion or not. 21-12 right now.
Well, I think didn't Coach Dunlop say at the beginning of the ballgame he didn't expect this one to be as high scoring as last year's, but it's moving in that direction. Last year, Syracuse got over 40 and they got over 20. Calabria throws it in the corner, but he is out of the end zone, no good.
If he was any further out, he could have gotten a hot dog while he was there. Yeah, he was way out of the end zone. Even if he came back in, he couldn't have caught the ball, because you can't go outside the field of play and come back in. So it's going to stay 21-12, give Syracuse a little bit of a break, but Colgate right back in it.
Still 4 minutes remaining in the first half. Again, at halftime last year, Syracuse was leading 27-14. There is Terenzi, just powers his way into the end zone. He had good momentum. He's a big guy. He's, I believe he's Colgate's biggest and heaviest running back. Weighs about 210 pounds, a six-footer.
Be interesting to see who Syracuse puts back at quarterback for the final 4 minutes of this half. Chris DiDullo, of course, didn't get the ball in a very good field position, but also didn't move the offense much at all.
Ryan Byrne approaches the ball, kicks it high and end over end, not deep. Gaydon at about the 7-yard line. Stop just short of the 25, or right at the 25-yard line. And the quarterback we're going to get is number 8, Greg Christodoulou.
In the second quarter,
a lot of people wonder why he plays two different quarterbacks. And talking to Coach McPherson, he feels that both freshmen have to get experience, and this is the way to do it, by alternating them on different series and different places in the game.
All right, Ziegler and Covington are the running backs. The give is to Jamie Covington to the 38-yard line. He is deceptively fast. I guess because he's a little bigger than what you'd expect a speedy back to be. He's broader. He's got a bigger chest, bigger shoulders, and you don't expect that he's going to be that fast, but he seems to be as fast as or faster than anybody chasing him. 122 yards for Covington on 16 carries. He has scored 2 touchdowns and thrown for 1. Morris in motion. Here's Jamie on a misdirection play. and he gets to about the 40-yard line.
Tripped up by Wolf, the linebacker.
Also in second quarter play.
As a matter of fact, he took Covington's shoe right off his foot, got an arm up on him, and Covington going to have to check out. Glenn Moore going to come back in at tailback.
Ziegler comes out, and Harold Gayden goes in at the other running back spot.
Syracuse would like to get at least one more on the board, whether it be a touchdown or a field goal.
Chris Tadula with wide receivers both ways. Gives it to Harold Gayden. And Gayden, behind number 65, Matt Walker, is left guard. Picks up three or 4 yards. Gets it to just short of the 45-yard line. Syracuse needs to get to about the 47 or 48. It'll be third down and round three with 2.5 minutes left to play in the opening half at the Dome. By Bruckner goes to the right, Hackett to the left. Harold Gayden, 3 carries for 15 yards. Chris Tadula rolling right. He's going to run with it. Gets just short of midfield. Number 55 knocks him down. That's Mark Rakowski.
Chris Tadula, obviously the best runner of the quarterbacks. I should say best of all three. We haven't seen Steve Beach, of course, since early in the season, but got the quick feet, and I think he knew right away he was going to run that ball, but he got the first down, and you see right there, that's 10-7 in first down department for Syracuse.
Here comes Covington. Nice cut by Jamie. Gets to the 47-yard line.
I'm just going to say, Larkin made the tackle. They try to get that go to the outside. What they like to have happen is over pursuit to the outside so the running back can cut it back up. But Larkin, number 54, nice job on pursuit, did not over pursue, and he held him to about a 3-yard gain.
Ziegler comes in with the play. Harold Gayden comes to the bench. Jerry Ferry breaks the huddle, comes out up over the ball. Less than 2 minutes to play in the first half. Syracuse has a 2nd and 7 from the Colgate 48. Hackett in motion. Into the 45-yard line. That'll leave Syracuse 4 yards short of the first down. Give Covington now 129 yards in 19 carries.
And the clock keeps right on running with these ground plays. We're down to just about 1:30 left to go in the first half.
This time, Mike Morris brings the play in as Nick Bruckner comes to the sideline. Morris goes to the right, Hackett to the left. Morris has the open side of the field. Signals. Chris Tadula back to throw, looking left. He won't get it away, but he breaks out. Gets back to about the 43-yard line. Going to be a yard or two short of the first down.
Boy, did he get manhandled on that. Avoided the rush at first from the outside by Colgate, but it's you see the rush coming from the outside. First man across was number 81, Kimmel.
Hard to believe he got out of
there. Yes, it is. Tackle made by 53, Rich White, a linebacker, but 4th and about 2.
He didn't make it. I don't believe Jamie Covington made the first down. The clock will stop with 32 seconds left to play in the first half.
Not a good way to end the half offensively for Syracuse, because this Colgate team is not about to give up. Obviously, they're only down 9 points. They've had some good offensive series lately, and Syracuse offense has got to be a bit frustrated.
Well, you look for Calabria to crank it up and just throw it as far as he can a couple of times.
Doesn't have anything to lose.
3 wide receivers. Calabria back. Being chased. Lets it go. Far short. Intended for number 20, Joe Kozak, but way short. Ron Hobby stumbled into him from behind and knocked him down. And went up and apologized to him.
Fans wanted intentional grounding, but that wasn't even close to that. He got the ball in the general direction, and that's all he had to do. Good pressure put on by Mike Charles and company inside. But Calabria's got good feet, able to get out of that. Boy, they drove him about 30 yards deep.
Calabria again back to throw. Charles after him. He gets it away. complete at the 40-yard line. Again intended for Kozak with David Lee, number 20. A pair of 20s came together at the 40-yard line, and the pass is incomplete.
David Lee.
17 seconds left to go in this first half, and the fans would like to see an interference call, I think, on Lee, but they don't get one. Very, very tight coverage. Lee checks out. They've still got four defensive backs in. Hobby's back in. Bellamy, Fredrickson, and Roos.
Colgate lining up with three wide receivers. They all break downfield. Calabria gets hit by Kimmel. Number 83, Jamie Kimmel on the stop along with Tim Green. And the clock is moving 5 seconds. Now the officials stop the clock with 4 seconds remaining in the first. We are ready to go from the 20-yard line. Ziegler and Covington are the running backs. Inside handoff to Ziegler, and he gets a yard and then gets driven back by. He was really hammered
Dave
as he tried to go straight ahead. That was the same play that opened the ball game. Opened the first half, opened the second half. First time Syracuse got the ball, they ran Ziegler straight ahead. Same thing here.
Wolf, the linebacker, number 50, just held his ground when he saw the opening. Boy, he just came up and